Hi, I'm Carol Scott, and I help astronauts get to the International Space Station. And this is Ask NASA.
Liftoff of the Falcon 9 and Crew Dragon. Go NASA, go SpaceX, Godspeed, Bob and Doug.
So Launch America is all about utilizing our commercial companies to be able to launch astronauts to the International Space Station from America's soil on American-made rockets. So this is a unique partnership that the government has formed with the commercial partners. We are leading and guiding them. We have provided SpaceX and Boeing, we've given them some requirements, and including where they've got to meet design and construction standards. Oh, there's tons and tons and tons of innovation going on. And the way that we're doing this allows the partners to be able to innovate even more. They're able to get that performance from some new technologies that they have on board. All those degrees of freedom are part of this commercial partnership, and it's awesome. So this is a historic launch because this is the first time that we've ever launched utilizing the commercial partners. We're buying a seat for astronauts. And so this is new. Just like if you were trying to buy a seat on an airline, this is gonna allow for a lot more access to space from other commercial partners, from other maybe potential tourism. And then in future generations, it'll be available to a lot more folks, just like you and I.
My name is Benjamin, and I am going to be a fifth grader next year. So what can my generation expect for Launch America?
So Ben, back in the 1920s and 1930s, the government transferred how we move mail. And that's how we got the airline industry started. And so this will be a very similar path with commercial space. You're gonna see a huge economic boom by NASA being able to transfer all this information to the commercial partners and letting them innovate to meet their business needs. And eventually they're gonna take additional passengers, just like the airlines did back then, additional passengers, and you will be able to go to space. You are gonna see human launches happening quite a bit here on the Space Coast. We wanna rotate every 6 months having astronauts' crews go up to the International Space Station. NASA still has a team of astronauts, but we have the capability to have commercial astronauts on board. So if, for instance, if you looked at Boeing, Boeing has Chris Ferguson, who was the last shuttle commander. He is one of their astronauts who will be taking the crew up in their CST-100 to the space station. So we can accommodate both NASA astronauts and commercial astronauts. And I believe you'll see a growing field of commercial astronauts very soon. Future missions are gonna be revolutionized by this process here. We're gonna be able to get more people up on space station. We're gonna get it to full capacity of personnel. And this will allow us to get more research done on the space station, getting more science, which will also help us here on Earth. With industry helping us get our astronauts to the International Space Station, NASA can focus on getting our first woman and the next man to the moon. We are absolutely using the commercial partners to be able to help us reach the moon. So they're going to be helping us with our human lander systems and being able to take cargo and supplies to the moon's surface, and that'll be ready for our crews to be able to use. So the hardest part of going to space, there's several different sections of it. If you work ground systems, you know, it's all about launching, right? But then you've got to be able to go through all the dynamic environments and being able to actually get into orbit. And then actually you got to go make it to your destination. So you've got to have all your guidance systems ready to take you where you want to go. And then you got to live in space, right? But then you've got to be able to return them safely, when they're ready to come back from being on station.
Do you have a question for NASA? Send your questions to our experts on Twitter using hashtag AskNASA.
For more episodes of Ask NASA, click the playlist.